Oh, by the way, duck your head. It's fixing to get kind of tight.
This week on Ray Van Horn's Captain's Journey.
This little lake is full of baby tarpon.
There he is.
Yeah! Hey! Gotta love this.
One right there. Look at that gator coming. Gotta be careful, Mr. Gator.
He says, come on, jump in.
Awesome little fish. Just beautiful.
I'm Ray Van Horn, and this is the Captain's Journey. Jump in the boat. Let's see what kind of fun we can have.
Ray Van Horn's Captain's Journey is presented by Ranger Boats, still building legends one at a time.
Get on board with Ray Van Horn, it's the Captain's Journey.
A while back, I got an email from a viewer, an avid fan of the show, I guess, and he said, Ray, he said, you get to fish some really cool places on your show, but what do you do when you got your day off? I thought that was kind of funny in a way because, well, I'll tell you what, I'm just going to show you. So come along with me, and let's see what kind of fun we can have. Oh, by the way, duck your head. Because it's fixing to get kind of tight. We're just gonna take our time and pick through here. It's gonna get a little thick right here. This is a 1652 Ranger aluminum boat. 16 feet, it's the perfect two-person boat. Floats skinny. Yeah. High water makes it a little tougher too. Ain't been nobody back here. I think I'm dragging a limb. No lure unit on this thing, just a jet. There's places all over this country where you can use a jet motor. Mercury makes a great one. Without a Bob's jack plate, I couldn't do that. They're tough, they're fast, they're durable, they last forever. Best warranty in the industry. They're a great company. Gonna have to lift it. Let's get up here and lift it.
Can we lift it?
Yeah, it's a stick. Come on, man.
Yeah, that's a long stick.
Without that Mercury jet and this Ranger 652, I couldn't enjoy what I like to do. We don't step on a rock. Like a ninja up there. Yeah, I gotta be able to see here. Yeah, this eliminates about 99% of the public. Dense it is back here, it's so awesome. Right over top of that log, brother. These are the things that knock the key out. Well, you got to have the right boat, number one. You can't bring anything pretty back here. Okay, lake's right here. See from the footage that we had to go through some pretty thick stuff to finally get back here to this little lake.
Okay.
This little lake is full of baby tarpon, and there's some snook back here. I'm telling you right now, probably hadn't been anybody back in here since the last time I was here. And it's way overgrown more than what it was last time. A lot of trees have fallen in from the storms and the wind. But now it's time to get busy and enjoy ourselves and have a little fun with a fly rod.
There he is. Man, that looked like a snook. I believe I got a, not a little tarpon. I'll tell you what, it don't get any better than that right there. Little popping bug. Plooch, plooch. He's close to the bushes. Come on, come on, little prince. Go ahead and land him before the alligator show up. Come here, boy. Okay, that's enough of that. Be good, be good, be good. I'll let you go. There we go. Look at that beautiful thing. Not huge, but I'll tell you what, these are my favorite ones. You can have them 200 pounders. Beautiful, 2-3 pounds. Thank you. Not so bad. If I don't catch another one, it was worth it right there. Although I did get a bath. I guess I need one after we had to go through all that junk.
Ray Van Horn's Captain's Journey is brought to you by Ranger Boats. Still building legends, one at a time. And by Mercury Marine. Go boldly.
All right, if you're just joining us, we're just showing you, you know, people say, Ray, what do you do on your day off, man? I know you travel over the country, you're filming, having a lot of fun. You live down in Chokoloskee, so what do you do on your day off? Well, this is it. I come back in here as far as I can, usually by myself. Usually bring nothing but a fly rod, box of flies, and have fun with MicroPoons. And usually there's some snook involved. Not today. It's crazy. I don't know where they went. This shouldn't take long. They don't like it. Need to put some new tippet on and a new fly. Gotta be one in there. Looks too good. There he is. Good one. Just gotta have the right fly, Ray. About a 20 pounder, maybe. 15. It wasn't my first cast, but it was my second. And man, he smoked it. Good fish, folks. Whoa! Doing what tarpon do. Here he comes again. Come on, Scooter, back here. Hey, when I'm in the backcountry, my favorite stick is usually a 7 or 8. I was using an 8 today because I was anticipating a little wind, but the 8-weight also has more backbone. So if I get into a big tarpon or a big snook, I've got enough rod to horse them out of the trees. I bank on Nautilus reels. It's the only reel I've ever used, made right here in the United States in Miami. For my money, the finest reel that you can buy for fly fishing. A little better fish there, folks, has an unbelievable drag. And that's the whole key to a good fly reel, is having a seamless drag. 8-weight fly rod, 9-footer, weight forward, floating line, 50-pound tippet. We started off, we were catching them on popping bugs, and I had gone from a popper because when we first started, it was pretty dark, overcast. And just to get a little noise out there, let them know we're here. As soon as the sun came out, all of a sudden the sun started to come out, and they were just rolling at the popper, not sucking it down. Come here. He is full of himself. Not done yet. What was the fly that really caught him today, that chartreuse and white EP? Come on. There you go. Look around, let's make sure that gator's not around. Well, he ate it too. Okay. I'll show you the magic fly in a minute. How about that one, boys? It's a fun little dude right there. Put that EP fly on. It was like money. Love you, man. Love you. Awesome little fish. Just beautiful. Get him back in the pond. Make sure there's no gators. He's about ready. Oh, it just goes to show you. If they start rolling at that little bug on top, that's telling you, you gotta go down. I tried an all white one, it wouldn't even bump it. So I went to a chartreuse over the top white EP fly, Enrico Pugliese. It's got just a little bit of red on it, and I'm gonna have to retie that tip because he bit it all the way up to here. Double weed guard, so you can throw it right in the trees. But that's it right there, that chartreuse. I think they can just see it a little better. And there's no reason to argue with them, you know? But that's your fly. Second cast. Bam. All right, got to retie. That's 50 pound leader. Let me tell you something. There's some 40, 50, 60 pounders in here, and there's some 20 pound snook. And we're just getting started. So I'm gonna have a cold drink, retie this feather, and y'all go get a cold one. And join me right back here. Get on board with Raven Horn, it's the captain's journey.
Ray Van Horn's Captain's Journey is presented by Mercury Marine. Go boldly.
Makes me nervous when I can't see those gators. I mean, I have to approach these fish with power pole. Went from no wind to crazy. There's your gator. He said, what's going on, Skippy? Going back over here now. He rolled at it. There he is. Oh yeah, come on, baby. Look at that gator coming. Look at that gator coming, folks. Got to be careful. Oh, he's a big gator too, my God. I'm sorry, tarpon. If you're gonna live, you're gonna have to get me in the boat for a second. Okay. All right, folks, that's a lot of drama. I don't normally swing them in the boat like that, but he'll be okay. They're tough little hombres right there. Mr. Gator. Charles. Yeah, 1 minute I'm fighting big bull sharks. The next minute I got a 7-8. Oh, he's mad. He's got his mouth open. He's hissing. See him right there? All right, we're going to put him. Okay. Ooh, look at you, dude. I've always wanted to do that. I don't know if it works or not, but I don't think it does. He says, come on, jump in. All right, so we got about an 8-footer right here, mouth open, ready to chew. He came over here like somebody owed him a beer and some chicken. He's mad. You can look at him. He is mad. He says, Ray, come on, man. Give me that tarpon. Go get your own. Go get your own. Oh, God, I feel like there gotta be some drama. Okay. All right. Look at you, dude.
Hey,
you're messing up the show. Don't make me get the push pole out. Look at that. He ain't happy. They got their mouth open like that. They're not happy. Let's see. 2, 4, 6, 8, and about 9 feet. Might be 10. Oh, missed him. Eckman got it. Yeah, baby. Oh, here comes that gator. Not him again. Dude, you are causing me grief. Come over here. Here he comes. Come here, Mr. Tarpon. Don't do this. Where's he at? There he is. Okay. Another dandy. There's Leroy over there. Just keep on going, boy. There he is. Another one, just like the other one. Beautiful. Back in the pool. Bye-bye. Hey, dude. Dude. Really? All right, we're gonna take a break due to gator interference.
Ray Van Horn's Captain's Journey is brought to you by Power Pole, Shallow Water Anchor, Bob's Machine Shop, Go Fast, Go Shallow, Go Efficient, and by DOA, The Unfair Advantage.
Hey, if you've just joined us, you're catching me right here in between time. Tying a new fly on. This is a EP craft hair pilchard, what's left of it. I mean, it's chewed up, it's got one eye. I guess they don't care because it's just caught a bunch of them, but I'm gonna tie some more leader on and tie another fly on. And I'll tell you what, usually we catch snook, haven't caught any today, that's okay. As long as I catch a bunch of micro tarpon on fly, ain't all bad. No snook, amazing. Not even little ones. Oh, he missed it. That one got it. Yeah! Hey! Gotta love this. This is a blast. There you go. All right, that's good enough. Another beautiful fish. Where's he at? Right off the bow. Okay, you're going in right there. He's over there. Oh, missed him. Got that one. Another dandy. Oh, that was a jumper. Unbelievable how a fish that size can jump that high. Watch out. Oh, watch out. Here comes Elvis. Oh, I have got one upset lizard. Here's Elvis Mach 5. I mean, he has got it locked in, buddy. Here in the clipper. Another beautiful, beautiful, beautiful specimen.
I'll tell you what, there's days when I've caught 50, 100 of these things, all sizes. Put them over here. What a way to end the day, folks. I don't know how many I caught. I have no idea. But I can tell you, it's been a blast. And I'm glad you got to share this part of my journey. Until next week, tight lines. Go get you some of these EPs.
I want to thank Kenny Brown at Outdoor Resorts here in Chokoloskee. He's my man, provides great accommodations. He's got a wonderful marina. He's got a great store and outfitting shop.